This is the install and setup guide for Python on the macOS. In this course, we are going to be utilizing an older version of Python 3.9.5. You can utilize other versions of Python from around about 3.4, the latest current version being around 3.10 as of recording this tutorial. We don't need to go into any great detail regarding why we need to install Python, but let me just paint us a picture here. Your computer, by default, doesn't know how to recognize Python code. It doesn't know what to do with it. It doesn't know how to execute it for our processor to be able to process that data and then to actually execute our code, run our code. So we need to download Python, and that's going to provide our computer all the tools for it to be able to recognize the Python programming language, for it to be able to interpret that language into something that can be then processed by our processor and actually then run our code. Any other additional information about Python, the installation process, will be delivered in the course if appropriate. Let's just focus on the actual installation process. Right, so this is really simple. Now, there is only one place where you want to download Python, and that is python.org. So you can type in Python download, or you can go straight directly to python.org. So here you can see we're going to select python.org. So download Python, that should take us to the homepage. Now, this is new. So this is the homepage. Let me just zoom out a little bit here. Okay, so we're presented here with a download for Python 3.10.7. As you have probably already noticed, there are lots of different versions of Python. Now, Python is a very progressive language. It's constantly being developed and improved upon. When a new version of Python is released, typically what happens is that new features are added, and in addition to that, some features may be removed. Those features that are removed, those may be needed by older types of applications that were written in older versions of Python. So that's where you really need to be concerned about what version of Python you're using. Depends on potentially if you're working on any legacy older types of software. Now, as we are developing our own software here or working with software that will work with the latest versions of Python, we don't need to necessarily worry about what version we're utilizing. But as you saw in the previous slide, we are going to be utilizing Python 3.9.5. So we do have a few different options here. Let me just zoom out a little bit more. This is probably what you're looking at. So here I can select downloads and I can go to my operating system, macOS. And here I'm presented with a bigger list. So we can see all the different versions of Python that we can download. So as I've already said, we're going to download 3.9.5. So you can scroll down and look for it. Alternatively, we can press Command and F and just type in 3.9.5 here in the search, and you can see that takes us directly to the download. You can see from this list, there are two options. If you have an Intel CPU in your Mac, then you're going to use the Intel installer. If you have one of the later M1, M2 chips, then you're going to download the Universal 2 installer. If you're not too sure, then just download the Universal 2 installer. So on this machine I'm working with, it has an M1 chip, so I'm going to download the macOS 64-bit Universal 2 installer. So that will download to our download folder. Now I can just select this option up the top here. That would open up the installer. I can double click on that, and then that would take us to the installer window. The installation process should be a straightforward process. There's a number of steps here. You can just go through and click continue. Make sure you read the license. And then there isn't necessarily any reason for you to install Python in any other directory, although you may have additional hard drives that you want to use. Click continue, and then you can go ahead and click install. So I've already installed Python, so I'm not going to take you any further here, but press install. That should then install and show you a summary of the installation process. You can then go ahead and close that dialog window. So once you've installed Python, we can double check to see if it has installed correctly. So I'm going to press Command and Space to bring up Spotlight here. And I'm going to type in Terminal app, or just Terminal, to bring open or to open up a terminal. I can check which version of Python is installed by typing Python 3 space double dash and then version. So that tells me that I have Python 3.9.5 installed on this machine. If you do find yourself having any problems with the installation, then do check out Stack Overflow. Stack Overflow is a service where you can ask technical questions. Now, 99% of the time, the problem that you experience will have already been experienced by someone else, and you'll probably already find that someone has a resolution for that problem. So do check out Stack Overflow for any technical and programming problems that you might experience. Your computer should now be ready to start developing with the Python programming language.